Here we are at gate one. This is the main entrance exit point for junior and senior infants only. Parents are asked to bring the children to their line and teachers will bring the children into their classrooms. At home time, children are collected in this yard and exit through gate one. Miss Flood's senior infants will be exiting through gate two, and we ask that those parents make a socially distanced line outside gate two at 1:45 p.m. This is the door that Miss Tunney's junior infants and Miss Flood's senior infants will be using. This is the door that Miss Murphy's junior infants will be using. This is the door that Miss Quinn's junior infants will be using. This is the door that Miss Gorman's junior infants will be entering through. Here we are at gate two. As mentioned earlier, Miss Flood's senior infants will exit this gate at 1:45. Classes entering this gate are Mr. Delaney's fifth class and Mr. Ryan's sixth class. When you enter through gate two there, students will then continue on through this gate or door here, and this will be open and they'll continue into the school building. Mr. Ryan's class will go through the first door on the left when they go in here. Mr. Delaney's will come in here and take the second left here and go in through door L on the left. Here we are at gate three. This is a new gate for us and will be the main entry exit point for all classes in the new building. They are Miss Carley and Miss McCormack's third classes, Miss Priest and Miss McAteer and Miss Connolly's fourth classes, and Mr. Carley and Mr. Farrell's sixth. Third class, when they enter through gate three, you follow the path up here on the small pitch, follow it all the way around, come down here and enter into the senior yard. And Miss Carley's and Miss McCormack's classes will enter here then through door J. Fourth class pupils will come through gate three, make your way onto the path, then come along here, down the steps and through the door K. The sixth class pupils and Miss Connolly's fourth will come through gate three, onto the path, down the steps here, and follow all the way down around the corner here, as shown in the camera shot. Miss Connolly's class will enter here on the right hand side through door S. Mr. Carley and Mr. Farrell's classes will enter through door R here. Here we are at gate four, or the St. Mary's Park gate. This gate is going to be for first and second and Miss Riley's and Mr. Roach's fifth class pupils only. Only pupils from those classes are allowed in this gate. This is really important to ensure the safety of all. Some of you may have used this gate in the past, but for health and safety and the current conditions we're having to deal with, it's very important that it's just the first, second and Miss Riley's fifth class pupils that are using this gate. When you enter through gate four, you may make your way to the senior yard. Miss Riley's class can go straight to their prefab here on the right with entry through door E, room 23. And Mr. Roach's fifth class will go through the door beside it into the room which was formerly the parents' room. Miss McKeown's class can enter here through door F at this entry point here. Miss Farage's class will enter through door G here.
And a smile means friendship to everyone, though the mountains divide and the ocean.
Miss Lynch's class will enter through door P here. Mr. Dulonia's class will enter through door Q at this point. Here we are at gate 5. This gate will only be used at home time for Miss Farry and Miss McKeown's classes. We ask parents to make a socially distanced line outside this gate when collecting in the evenings. Thank you for your cooperation in working together to make our school a safe place for all. We look forward to seeing you all on Thursday.